Hello there, my name's Ms.RedNebula, and welcome to another Game Dev in Progress Diary. Of course, it's been a little while since the last one. I definitely feel like I got to a point where I just wasn't quite sure what I wanted to work on. I had done a bit more working on the pinball game, which was supposed to be the idea of, you know, you're supposed to start out with smaller projects before you really start thinking about that one big project, or in our case, probably about 3 or 4 big projects that you really, really want to work on, you know? But as it turned out, the scope of the pinball game was also kind of starting to creep up a little bit. And it really wasn't the kind of final project that I wanted to be spending my time on. Not to the amount that I would have needed to spend on it to really turn it into what I started to have in mind. So there's a couple of games that my husband and I have been bandying about a bit, and one of which is a 3D game that we started thinking, you know, well, I'm gonna just be making this really complicated project first off anyway, might as well start off with the project that we really, really want to make, you know? So I spent some time trying to work out a character controller in Unity that I was happy with, and kept running into a lot of frustrations with this, like just not having a good time getting the jump routines to work properly. And so I took a bit of a detour and went over to play around with Unreal Engine 4 for a little while. I know a couple of people had suggested taking a look at it, and I will say that the character controller that they have that's built into UE4 is really, really good, very powerful. But I just wasn't feeling that comfortable working in that program, so back to the drawing board. Kind of started feeling like, no matter what I was working on, that I just didn't really have enough of a grounding in solid theory and solid being able to write the code and everything that I needed to do myself. Part of it was, I thought, you know, maybe I'll go back and do a few more tutorials and stuff. And then inspiration came in the form of, well, a guy called Yahtzee, if you're familiar with The Escapist. He's a sort of a game reviewer, and very, very funny, very deadpan. If you haven't watched him, I highly recommend his show Zero Punctuation. It's hilarious, and even when he's poking fun of games that I absolutely love, he's still hilarious, so I'll forgive him for really, really hating Detroit Become Human. What can I say? I like that game. But what he's been doing recently is he's doing some game development too. Now, he's done game development in the past, but now he really wants to focus on that idea of going ahead and making very quick turnaround games, and he's making 12 games in the next 12 months, or at least that's what he intends to do. But a lot of this had to do with, again, back to that idea of the first games that you make really need to be small. They need to be something you can just come up with a couple of ideas, finish relatively quickly, like ideally within a month. I mean, obviously there's game jams that people do that where they're finishing games in a couple of days, but I think you need to have more of a solid grounding in what you're doing before you can really do stuff like that. You know, I'm trying to come up with concepts, and it takes me, when I was working on the pinball stuff, it took me an entire day to get the rotation correct on the flipper. That doesn't really make it tenable to finish a game in 2 days. So, like I said, back to basics. Came up with a concept that is genuinely a simple game. No story, nothing too crazy and fancy. Really, I think it would probably qualify far more as a casual game than anything else, but I really want to make something that I can create and actually finish. So for this one, the concept that I'm going for was kind of inspired by our cats begging for food in the kitchen. So the original idea came from trying to figure out something that had to do with dropping food and some kind of a critter going after it. And after a little bit, this morphed into a rat in the sewer. Don't ask me, but it took a few steps to get there, but that's what it turned into. So we've got this simple idea of a rat running back and forth in a sewer, trying to catch food items as they're dropping from the sewer grate up above. Just like a game like Tetris, it simply gets faster and faster as you go, and there's a few conditions that would make it so that your character would die. Like, you fall off the edge of the platform, or there would be these rat poison pellets dropping down from above that you have to avoid, and a few other fun things as well. But that's the concept. Keep it simple. Nothing fancy, this is just a straightforward game that I do truly believe that I can finish in a month and actually have out there where you guys can take a look at it and play it. So here's a bit of concept art that I was scribbling around on paper, trying to come up with how do I want this character to look, what kind of a design do I really want this game to have. Everything's very whimsical, very playful, all nice and silly, lots of very bright colors, the whole proportions of things don't really matter in something like this, it's just for fun. And then, of course, because I hadn't really touched on 2D stuff in any of these platforms so far, I went and did some 2D tutorials. Actually found these tutorials by a guy called Daniel Wood that turned out to be really, really helpful. Felt like I had a decent grounding in 2D stuff, and that combined with, of course, the 2D and 3D have a lot of similarities in Unity, so some of it I already knew, and some of it was brand new because I hadn't worked a huge amount with sprites and stuff before. Unity's got a pretty good feel when it comes to doing 2D stuff, and there's a lot of very well-made 2D games that were created in Unity, for example, like Ori and the Blind Forest, or probably one of the most stunning examples being Cuphead. So now I had my basis in how do you do stuff in 2D in Unity, I decided to throw together a little bit of a mock-up. What's nice is that you can take some of the example graphics that the Unity store has available for free and kind of kitbash a game together. Obviously none of this is going to be the final graphics, but at least you can see how does stuff move and how exactly is your game going to go together, and then replace all of that with custom graphics and some fancier stuff as time goes on. So the first thing that I did was, of course, had my character just running back and forth, which fortunately is a very simple thing. I was back and forth on having a jump mechanic, but there are a couple of things that I think I want to try to add into this game that the jump mechanic would work for, plus it just makes it a little bit more likely that you accidentally fall off the edge, so it seemed like it added more to the game than just having your character run back and forth, so I decided to leave that in as well. And then what I wanted to have happen was something that you see in a lot of games, which is that you've got multiple spawn points up at the top of the screen where all of the different food items and then the unhealthy items are going to drop down from. So I set up a system whereby there were as many spawn points as I needed, and from those spawn points would randomly be generated one of a certain number of prefabbed objects, which would be food items, poison pellets, and maybe some other stuff too. Managed to get it so that you had it randomly deciding between these different spawn points and then randomly deciding what object it wanted to go ahead and spawn. Right now, of course, there's still a lot of problems with this. I'm instantiating and then destroying objects over and over and over again, and I know that that's not a good practice, especially when you've got a lot of objects being used in your game, and those same objects being used over and over again. There's a thing called object pooling that I'm aware of, but I really need to find a couple of tutorials to see exactly how it works and how I'm going to integrate it into my game. Also, because right now, only the objects that are touching our little character are disappearing. Anything dropping down below the screen just remains, and of course that's really a bad thing because you just have more and more objects being added to the game over time. That means that eventually you're going to run out of memory and the whole thing's going to crash and burn. So obviously I've still got some stuff that I need to tweak and all of that. I mean, the timing's not anywhere near where I want it to be just yet, but I was really quite pleased that I got this working with relatively little hassle. So that's what I've got for this one. Feel free to like or comment, and if you want random updates from my little world of art and gaming, subscribe. If you enjoy what I do and are interested in supporting the channel, check out my Patreon. A big thank you to my current patrons. That's all for now. Bye!